All right, for the plaintiff, Mr. Eckhart, we have a depot. So Sarah in the court chair is Mr. Connor, and she's already changed that. Very good, Sarah. Matt is regular defense, Mr. Folino, and I'm the witness. And we will be doing 200 words a minute. Mr. Eckhart, beginning in examination.
Ready, begin. Would you tell us when you received such information and the form in which you received it?
Prior to starting my shift on the evening of this occurrence.
And who gave you the information?
Sergeant Ralph Zillett.
And where was this received by you?
At 77th District Police Station.
Was it in writing or verbally?
It was in writing.
And could you describe the writing to us?
It was a yellow piece of teletype copy, appeared to have been torn from a machine.
Did you have an opportunity to read it?
Yes, I did.
Could you tell us in substance what it said?
It stated that, I don't recall all of the facts that were included in the teletype, stated, as I recall right now, that there were five males. It described each of the five persons. It also stated that these five persons were wanted in connection with a series of robberies that had been committed in the Gardena and South Central portion of Los Angeles. It stated that these persons had been holding up markets and liquor stores, that they were armed, and I don't recall the rest of the information reset that was contained on it.
In reading the teletype, did you read the piece, the place of its origin?
I did.
Could you tell us where that was?
I don't recall.
Now, had you seen similar teletypes on other occasions?
I have.
Do you know what was normally done with them in terms of keeping or preserving them?
They're kept on a clipboard for a couple of days, at which time the oldest reports are removed. I don't know other than that. I don't know what happened to them.
Does the clipboard have a name?
Not that I know of.
Do you know where the clipboard is normally kept?
Either in the watch commander's office or the detective bureau.
And would that be the 77th Street Precinct?
That's right.
Now, had you ever seen this teletype again after that evening? That is, when you went on shift and before today?
Not that I can recall.
Had you testified under oath to any other person with reference to the contents of this teletype report?
No.
Is Sergeant Zillet still at the 77th Street Precinct?
Still assigned, yes, sir.
Incidentally, since the happening of this occurrence, had you been at any time suspended for the events in connection with this shooting?
No.
Have you continued regularly working?
Yes.
Has any, to your knowledge, investigation been conducted by the police department or the city of Los Angeles into the circumstances of this shooting?
Not to my knowledge.
Has anyone asked you to make a statement, either verbally or in writing, before today as to how those occurrences happened?
Officially, do you mean?
Yes.
No.
I don't mean talking with the city attorney before giving your deposition here. I am referring to such things as any investigation by some sort of internal affairs.
Yes.
All right. First of all, has there been any investigation to your knowledge by any investigating board in the investigation of the shooting?
Not to my knowledge.
Have you appeared before any superior and given any formal declaration, whether or not under oath, as to how this occurrence happened?
No.
Have you, to the state, received either verbally or in writing any notice or any disciplinary action taken or contemplated against you?
None.
Prior to today, and except in connection and solely in connection with your preparation for your deposition reset, had you seen any reports or photographs, diagrams, or written statements with reference to the premises of the Golden State Market and Liquor Store and the happening of this occurrence?
I made out a written report to my attorney, Mr. Connor, regarding the facts involved.
Mr. Connor is a private attorney.
No, it is this gentleman sitting in the corner.
In other words, the city attorney.
That's correct.
And how long after the incident did you make out such report?
I don't recall exactly.
Was it some substantial time before today?
Yes.
Had you written any other report at all or given any other statement other than to Mr. Connor with reference to the facts of this occurrence?
No.
Are you familiar with the contents of the police tactical manual with the use of firearms, which was in effect on October 17, 2009?
Part that applied to me, yes.
Had you ever had occasion to study the manual before that day?
No.
Had you ever, as opposed to just studying it, had you ever read it before the day of this occurrence?
Portions.
When you first came to work for the city of Los Angeles, was that as a policeman?
Yes.
And had you had any previous experience prior to that time?
Yes.
Where?
City of Long Beach.
For how long?
3.5 years.
And prior to working for the city of Long Beach, had you had any prior police experience?
No.
Would you tell us what your education had been until the time you first went to work for the city of Long Beach?
High school education and a few college courses.
Did any of those college courses deal with police science?
None.
At which college were they taken?
University of Alaska and Long Beach City College, and I believe that's all.
Can you remember the date in which you were last in attendance at Long Beach City College or the year?
Last year.
When you went to work for the Long Beach Police Department, I take it then, you had not been at that time going to Long Beach City College.
That's correct.
Had you then been to the University of Alaska?
Yeah.
What did you study there?
Business management and sociology.
When you went to work for the city of Long Beach, did you have any training in police science?
No.
That is, at no academy or school or anything of that sort which was conducted by the city of Long Beach as a policeman?
After employment, the city of Long Beach did put me in their police academy.
How long did it last?
Well, pardon me, I'm not certain.
Did it relate in part to the approved method of making arrests and to the use of firearms?
Yes, it did.
And whatever the contents of that course was, you had studied that at least some time prior to this occurrence and while you were employed by the city of Long Beach?
That's correct.
Now, can you remember the date upon which you first became employed by the city of Los Angeles?
October 21, 2 years ago.
Did the city of Los Angeles, after employment or before, have any type of an academy or school in connection with your work?
Yes.
Can you tell us what it was and how long it lasted?
It was a class which involved classroom and physical training, and it lasted approximately 12 weeks.
And during the course of that phase of police training, did you study any portion of the police tactical manual on the use of firearms?
Yes.
Could you tell us which portions you studied at that time?
I think it was the general shooting policy of the department.
Is that the name it is referred to as, general shooting policy?
The shooting policy.
Was this a separate chapter of the manual?
I don't know.
Do you remember whether it was entitled or captioned the shooting policy?
I don't know.
Was there any chapter in the manual or any portion in the manual which you read in it to the use of firearms in making arrests?
Yes.
Was there any chapter in the report or manual which you read during this period of training that related to the use of firearms in the course of an investigation as opposed to an arrest?
Yes.
And did you read all of those portions during the course of your 12 weeks of training?
Yes.
Do you remember whether you were examined on them?
Yes.
And did you pass the examination?
Yes.
Now again, when you took the examination, was that on a printed form?
As I recall, it was.
True or false sort of thing?
I don't recall.
Or multiple choice, maybe?
I'm not certain.
In any event, you remember it was some kind of printed form?
Yes.
And you filled things in somehow?
Somehow.
And put your name on it?
Yes.
And the date?
Yes.
Who did you turn it into?
I don't recall.
Did you keep the portion of the manual which you studied in school?
I don't recall.
Well, as of the date of this occurrence, did you have, either in your unit or your locker or in the precinct or at your house, any part of the manual to which you had been referring?
I don't recall.
Do you have any such parts now?
Possibly. I don't know.
Do you remember when the last time was, in terms of time, before this occurrence in which you have reviewed or remade any portions of the manual to which we've been referring?
I don't recall.
Had you received any classes during the 12-week course on the use of the firearm, and that is to say, aside from a mere reading or explanation of a manual?
Yes.
Do you remember the name of your instructor or instructors?
No, I don't.
In the course of the 12-week training, did you take more than one examination on the contents of the class?
Of which class?
Well, was there just one final examination at the end of the 12 weeks, or did you have to take examinations more than once?
We had to take many examinations.
And to turn them in to your superior.
That's right.
Now, is this all at the academy?
Yes.
Does it have anything more in its name other than the Los Angeles Police Academy?
No.
Where is it located?
On Academy Road in the city of Los Angeles.
Do you know who the head of that academy is?
No, I don't.
Do you have a personnel file?
I imagine.
I suppose you have heard of such things anyway?
Yes, I have.
But nobody has ever let you look at it.
No.
Do you have any idea where your personal file is maintained?
At 150 North Los Angeles Street.
Do you know the name of the designation of the department, that is, the sub-department, where it is maintained?
No, I don't.
Had you ever shot any firearm at any person at any time before the date of this occurrence?
Yes.
How many occasions?
One occasion.
How long before this occurrence did that happen, approximately?
Approximately 2 years.
I take it then that that was just about the time you left the Long Beach Police Department.
I'm not certain of the exact date.
Were you employed by Long Beach at the time this occurred?
Yes.
And did your leaving the police force have anything to do with your taking a shot at some person?
No, it didn't.
Did you strike or wound the person on that occasion?
Yes.
Did you wound or kill him?
Wounded him.
Did you subsequently make an arrest of that person?
Yes.
Was there any type of disciplinary proceeding that occurred subsequent to the shooting while you were at Long Beach?
No.
Was there any investigation conducted onto the facts and circumstances of that shooting?
I don't know.
Are you aware whether you ever appeared before anybody and gave your version of how that happened?
I'm aware whether I did or not, yes.
And did you?
No.
Do you know of any record other than your own ordinary records kept as a policeman that is the equivalent of your daily activities in Long Beach, a record of that occurrence in Long Beach?
The arrest report of the person, yes.
Do you remember the name of that person?
No, I don't.
Did the person subsequently recover?
Yes, he did.
What kind of a wound was it?
I don't know.
Did it occur in a liquor store?
No.
Where did it occur?
On the street.
Can you give me just a brief resume of what happened at that time?
He was a suspect wanted in connection with a grand theft auto and narcotics charge, and he committed a battery on myself and was attempting to escape arrest.
At that time, you shot him?
That's right.
Had you ever been in the military service?
Yes.
Which branch?
Air Force.
For what inclusive years?
1999 through 2003.
Incidentally, when you came to work for the city of Los Angeles, were you required to fill out an application as a condition of your employment?
Yes.
Did you give information about yourself?
I did.
And in that application, incidentally, was that a printed form?
Yes, it was.
Do you know who you turned it over to?
I don't recall his name.
Do you know where it is maintained?
No, I don't.
In that application, did you describe this occurrence in the city of Long Beach?
No, I didn't.
Had you ever at any time prior to today informed any person in the employ of the city of Los Angeles about this occasion in Long Beach?
No.
All dispatches which you received on your beat during the 7 months before this occasion came from the same dispatcher's office, did they not?
I don't know.
Well, it came over the same frequency.
That's correct.
You had only one frequency on your radio?
No.
How many frequencies did you have?
I believe there was 3 or 4.
And did you listen to more than one dispatch statement simultaneously?
Not simultaneously, no.
But you could switch from channel to channel?
That's right.
You say you were in the Air Force?
Yes.
Did you fly?
No.
Have anything to do with radios?
No.
Well, there are some radios that have a little switch on that you just flip from one channel to another with a switch. Was that kind of channel you had in your radio unit?
That's correct.
How is it that you happen to be tuned to one station as opposed to another at any given time?
It would depend on the type of activities that I was involved in at that particular time.
All right. Would you describe to me what channels with reference to what activities?
The primary channel is the channel used for the division to dispatch and receive information from the police patrol unit. The other units are used for car-to-car communications and for operations that would not tie up the primary channel.
And at the time you received this dispatch, did you receive it over the primary channel?
Yes.
Now at the time of the dispatch, did they designate your particular unit?
No.
What was said with reference to what units would respond?
A unit number was given.
Was that your unit?
No.
Do you remember whose unit it was, whether or not you remember the number?
No, I don't.
Now where were you when you first heard this dispatch?
Across from 8551 South Broadway.
That is a liquor store?
That's right.
Were you on Broadway at that time?
Yes.
Did you immediately, upon hearing this dispatch, then call in to the dispatcher?
I don't recall.
Or have car-to-car communications?
I don't recall.
When you first heard the dispatch, were you moving?
Yes.
In which direction were you going?
Northbound.
Was the liquor store then clearly in view?
Yes, it was.
Were there any obstacles in your way in the place where your car was and the liquor store?
Vehicle traffic, other traffic.
Do you remember in which lane you were?
No, I don't.
Incidentally, you weren't parked at the time you heard the dispatch.
That's correct.
All right. What did you do upon hearing the dispatch?
I don't understand what you mean. What did I do?
All right. You heard the dispatch on the radio.
Okay.
You have a partner in the car.
That's right.
And his name was?
Officer McCaff.
Did you say anything to Officer McCaff?
Yes.
What did you say?
I don't recall.
Did he say anything to you?
Yes.
What did he say?
I don't recall.
Was Officer McCaff driving?
Yes, he was.
Did you suggest to Officer McCaff that you pull into the liquor store?
I don't recall whether I did or not.
Of course, you looked across the street at the liquor store.
Yes.
And apparently you saw nothing over there that so excited your suspicions that you thought you should report it over the radio to anyone.
That is an unfair question, counsel. I object to the form of the question.
You have been behaving very nicely in terms of objection, so I will just withdraw the question. Could you see in the liquor store?
The building?
Could you see anybody inside?
I couldn't see anybody inside.
Why?
We were moving. There was other traffic moving. I didn't really attempt to see inside other than to observe the outside and the persons on the outside.
Would you describe to us what you saw on the outside then at that moment in time?
Just a liquor store.
You didn't notice any cars in the parking lot?
The parking lot wasn't visible.
Did you see any people pausing about the outside of the premises?
No, I didn't.
And were you exactly opposite the liquor store, proceeding in a westerly direction, or were you to the north or to the south when you first heard the call?
Well, the calls took a certain amount of time to come out, at which time we were traveling from Manchester to the corner. I don't know what distance that is.
And would you describe the course that your car took after hearing the dispatch?
Officer McCaff turned the vehicle in the opposite direction.
Would that be a U-turn?
Yes.
And there was moving traffic on the street?
There was traveling on Broadway at that time, yes.
And you were traveling on Broadway?
Yes.
So you made a U-turn on Broadway?
Officer McCaff made a U-turn.
For that purpose, did you utilize your light or siren?
No.
Just waiting for an opportunity for traffic to clear?
I didn't. I sat on the passenger side.
To your knowledge, he didn't?
I don't recall.
At least you don't remember any?
No.
And you didn't hear any?
No.
How are you dressed?
In a police uniform.
What color was it?
Dark color.
Was the heater on in the car?
I don't recall.
Wearing some kind of jacket, weren't you?
I don't recall.
And when the dispatch was given, were you apprised at that time, apprised that it was a silent alarm, right?
That's right.
I think that's what you told me when we first started out.
I believe so.
So you didn't have in mind that this would be, and in fact, most probably would be a false alarm.
I object to that question. Ambiguous.
No, I didn't.
Withdraw it, all right. Did you have in mind at the time that you heard this dispatch that this could be a false alarm?
No, I didn't.
Did you believe it to be?
No.
Did you believe that there was in progress at the place to which you were dispatched some kind of robbery or burglary?
Yes.
At the moment you heard the dispatch?
At the approximate time that I was in that area, yes.
All right. Were you armed?
Yes, I was.
What kind of weapon?
A Smith & Wesson revolver.
What caliber?
It is a .357 pistol.
That sometimes is referred to as a Magnum?
Yes.
Does it have any special kind of ammunition?
Did it or does it? I don't understand the...
Did it have?
It didn't have any special type of ammunition.
Was it a special type of jacket, if you recall? What type of bullet was?
I don't know. I don't know anything about bullets.
Did either you or your partner in your car in the immediate area in which your unit was being dispatched call in to the dispatcher to advise that you were, in fact, in that area?
I don't recall right now.
Had you ever been in the dispatcher's office in the 77th precinct?
No.
Did the call, to the best of your knowledge, come from the 77th precinct?
I don't know.
Do you know whether any recording, either by tape or otherwise, is made of the conversations on the primary frequency, that is, between the dispatcher and the unit?
I don't know.
Did you talk with your fellow officer about the possibility as to whether or not this could be a false alarm before actually getting to the liquor store?
I don't recall.
And had you given us the full content of the dispatch as nearly as your memory will permit, realizing it's been several months?
As I recall it, yes, I did.
Now, when you heard the dispatch, did you hear the dispatcher address any one unit which was other than yourself?
I don't recall if other units were dispatched or called, or I don't recall whether it was in all units or not. I'm not certain.
In any event, if he dispatched more than one unit, you don't remember?
I don't remember.
Did you hear any car-to-car conversation between the time you first heard this dispatch and the time you reached the liquor store?
No.
Did the unit in which you were riding have any type of rifle or shotgun in it?
No.
Did you have any type of weapon other than the revolver that you have described to us?
No.
After making the U-turn on Broadway, did the car then proceed directly to the liquor store?
No.
Where did it go?
It stopped a distance north of the liquor store.
How far?
I'm not certain.
At the curb?
No.
Could you describe to me where it stopped with reference to the liquor store?
Approximately, I'm not certain, maybe 25 yards north.
Was this in a parking lot?
No.
Could you describe the place where it stopped?
a driveway, I don't know, partially on the sidewalk or straddling the sidewalk.
So the car pulled into a driveway?
Pulled, yes, that's correct.
Would that be a residence driveway?
No.
What type of driveway?
A business driveway.
And this was approximately 25 yards north of the liquor store?
Approximately.